If you're in the market for a power station, we have to warn you that most companies overinflate their specs and the capabilities of what their products can actually do, including one of the biggest brands, EcoFlow. We talked a lot about this in our recent video, Who is EcoFlow? When we gave kind of a backstory of who they are and how they got started, and how every single time they were gonna release a new power station, they basically overpromised and underdelivered to everyone who supported them on their crowdfunding pages. Great job. In recent years, they have gotten a little bit better, but they still can't seem to shake this one idea that they keep trying to sell people, which is XBoost. So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. In almost every single EcoFlow video that we have done, we basically just say XBoost is fake news and skim right over it.
XBoost is kind of a gimmick.
I'm always gonna hit on XBoost whenever we're talking about EcoFlow.
Next thing we don't like is XBoost. The EcoFlow XBoost is fake.
And based on some of the comments, you guys are torn. Either you think we're complete idiots and we don't know what we're talking about, thank you, or you agree with us and you think that XBoost is just a marketing tool, doesn't really work as advertised, and you thank us for calling out companies that need to be called out. You're welcome. But regardless of what you think, we never actually explain what XBoost is. We always just breeze right over it. So today we're gonna give you guys a little bit more info on what it is, how it works, and let you guys decide if you think it's fake news or not.
This is CNN breaking news.
Essentially, XBoost is a feature that allows a power station's inverter to support appliances with a higher power demand than the inverter is actually rated for doing. For example, there might be an EcoFlow power station with a 1200 watt inverter, and they say with XBoost it can power devices up to 1800 watts, which is great, but it's not actually providing real power at 1800 watts. The way it does this is by manipulating voltage on the appliance to basically trick it into thinking that it's getting the right amount of power when it's not. To make it make as much sense as possible, whenever you look at an appliance, how much power it uses, we talk about watts. The bottom of your vacuum, your fridge, it'll say how many watts that appliance uses. And the way you get watts is volts times amps. Now, if you're using regular 120 volt house plugs, it's 120 volts. So for example, if you had a device that was 10 amps, at 120 volts, that'd be 1200 watts. The 1200 watt inverter in the example would run it no problem. If you had a device that was 15 amps at 120 volts, that would be 1800 watts. So technically, the XBoost would still be able to run that appliance. The way it does this though is by essentially dropping the voltage. We refer to this all the time in our videos as pulling voltage. So it'll take 120 volts and it'll start pulling it till it's like 90 volts, because 90 times 15 is 1200. It's basically just pulling the voltage as much as possible to trick the appliance to still run, but the appliance won't be running at full power capacity. It's not a true power increase. If you were to look at a light bulb that's plugged in when we're doing one of these XBoost experiments, the light bulb dims dramatically. Like, you can see the light go down. If you were to listen to a heat gun, when a heat gun's running, you can hear it sounds normal. As soon as you start entering stages of XBoost, whether that's a little bit over or all the way to the maximum of the XBoost, you can hear the heat gun drop in volume. Because sure, it's running, but it's not running the way it was intended to. It's running at 80 or 70% efficiency, which is maybe fine for a heat gun, something like a kettle or something like that. It would just take a longer time to actually heat up. So at the end of the day, what we're trying to say here is it's not a true power increase, it's a trick. So personally, we find XBoost is just misleading to people. That's the main thing that we don't like about it. Sure, it may work, but most people aren't gonna take the time to research what XBoost is and look into it. They're just gonna see that it can, oh, actually power devices at up to 1800 watts, cool. And then they're gonna go ahead and make that purchase, assuming XBoost is actually gonna do the job for them when it might not. Plus, it's actually very harmful to your devices. So if you're running a resistive load, like we already talked about, examples like a space heater, a heat gun, a kettle, stuff like that, it'll still work. It'll just take longer to do its job because it's not running at 100% efficiency. If you're trying to run sensitive electronics like a computer, a CPAP machine, or something like a refrigerator, you can do pretty major damage to those components if you're not giving them the required stable voltage. A computer is probably the most easy to understand for everybody. Basically, if your computer is supposed to get 110 to 120 volts and you're running it at 90 or 100, what can happen is two things. The first one is your CPU and GPU, things that are very, very sensitive, we're gonna have to work a lot harder to be able to get the job done because they don't have enough voltage. So they're gonna be overworking, but the computer's not designed to cool them when they're working this hard. So they're gonna end up overheating and cause problems. And the other thing that can happen is basically all of the individual components inside of your computer don't have enough power to share. So the computer is gonna start acting erratically. It's gonna start acting out. It's gonna basically have a stroke because not everything is getting the right voltage. So this piece over here might work, but this piece doesn't. So you can actually have tons of problems. You can have your computer start having memory loss. It can literally just crash. Your computer's gonna start acting like a toddler with ADHD.
Or tiny baby when he's hungry.
And then it's gonna grow up to be tiny baby, a hungry, defective monster. So at the end of the day, it works. It's great to surge a device. If you have a 1200 watt device that surges at 1800 watts, sure, the XBoost will help do that. But generally they advertise this more in the small, like a River 3, where it's like a 300 watt inverter with a 600 watt XBoost. Like nothing that small is gonna surge. At least now we've explained it to you guys. So when we breeze over it in future videos, you guys have some sort of reference point to come back to learn what it's actually all about. But let us know what you guys think. We're not trying to attack EcoFlow or be dicks. We're just trying to say we don't really think it's the best marketing tool. That's all we got for you guys. Make sure you guys are subscribed. We will catch you in the next one. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.